I have a reason for asking also.
Okay. Wait and see if I give the right answer. Okay, what is the vagus nerve? That's a good question. Vagus, V-A-G-U-S, vagus.
As opposed to Las Vegas.
Las Vegas, right, it's different. Vagus is Latin for wanderer. And it turns out most of your nerves come out of your spinal cord. If you think of the spinal cord, it kind of looks like a centipede with all the little branches coming off. And they all come out here and they all kind of look like the stripes on a zebra. Okay? But some of your nerves, a very small number, 12 in fact, come out of the base of the brain. They're called the 12 cranial nerves. And one is the ocular nerve to your eye, very specialized nerve. And the auricular nerve to your ear, to hear. And there's one that goes to your face called the trigeminal nerve. There's one that shrugs your shoulders called the spinal accessory nerve. And one of them's called the vagus. And it wanders from the base of the brain down next to the carotid artery, next to the heart, down into the abdomen, and goes through some of the organs in the abdomen. And what does it do? Well, we've been finding that out for years. We keep finding new things. The most recent thing that they have discovered is if you put a little electrical pacemaker on your vagus nerve and fire the pacemaker, you'll get happy. So there's now an FDA-approved treatment for depression where you put a pacemaker under the skin, attach two wires to the vagus nerve here, and the patient's depression gets better.
Interesting.
Right? So that patient, I have one of those patients coming to see me, and his wife is wound up tight about me cutting his vagus nerve. Because is he going to get sad? Well, the point is the vagus goes this way and that way, and this part I won't affect because I'm going to be cutting it down here. But the vagus does other things, like it innervates the heart.
Okay.
Gives parasympathetic stimulation to the heart. So have you ever heard of fainting? Yes. Did you know that fainting can also be called a vasovagal?
Yeah.
You got the vasovagal?
That's why I was asking. Because
okay.
I've had, in drawing blood, I've actually lost consciousness one and a half times.
Mm-hmm. So that's called a vasovagal episode, and we won't affect that because we're going to be below that.
Okay.
Just like we're not going to make the one guy unhappy because we cut the vagus down here.
Okay.
Because it has afferent going back to the brain and efferent coming out of the brain fibers.
Okay.
Now, we've also known for many years that cutting the vagus nerve by the stomach causes a decrease in acid in the stomach. And in the olden days, before Tagamet and Zantac and cimetidine and Prilosec, the third most common general surgical procedure was operations on the stomach for ulcers. And one of those operations was a vagotomy, cut the vagus nerve, and antrectomy, or a vagotomy and pyloroplasty. So cutting the vagus is something that we have done for almost 100 years, really more like 50 years. It's actually invented by another one of my teachers at the University of Florida. But when he invented it, he was at the University of Chicago. So what they found is in dogs, if you cut the vagus nerve by the stomach, and there are two branches of it, that the stomach acid will go down and ulcers will go away. So the vagus nerve was known for about 50 years to be involved in the stimulation of acid in the stomach. Now, most recently, the most exciting thing for people who are heavy is the finding that obesity may not be related to your character. Everybody's heard the following. Everybody's heard this. Obesity is really simple. It's calories in and calories out. You want to lose weight, all you got to do is eat less and exercise more. Heard that one? Common sense, right? Just makes perfect sense. Well, so then what's your problem, right? Well, people say, well, if I tell you that and you don't know how to handle that, then you must have a weak character. Or you have something wrong with you. Mama didn't like you best when you were growing up. And so you have sadness inside. And to reach out and fill the hole where mama never loved you, you eat cookies. You heard that one? And if you see me on a regular basis on Tuesdays and Thursdays for an hour, we'll talk until the inner child feels better. You'll get over this sadness, and then you won't have to eat the cookies all the time. Okay, so let's put aside that explanation for obesity, sadness, lack of willpower, gluttony, you heard all those, that kind of. Let's instead say, God created heaven and earth, and he gave all of us as animals a hunger hormone, because cats and rats and bats and mosquitoes and human beings all need to know to eat sometime and eat a certain amount and not too much and not too little. If your cat eats too little every day, he'll starve to death. If your cat eats too much every day, he'll become overweight. And we have found a hunger hormone called
Ghrelin.
It comes out of the stomach, and release of ghrelin is mediated in part by the vagus nerve. So if you take mice and cut the vagus nerve, they eat about 10% less. Also, it helps us understand that hormones may be involved in obesity. And maybe it's not just character or willpower or goodness. Now, not only have we found out about ghrelin, but we found out about another hormone called peptide YY. Ghrelin makes us hungry, and peptide YY makes us feel full. Or the big scientific name is satiated. Now, if you were going to put an I'm full hormone in the bowel, if you were God, where would you put it? Well, he put it at the end of the small bowel. When it's all filled up with food, when the stream of food fills up the bowel, peptide YY goes up. Okay, so now we have two hormones, and there may be more. One makes you hungry, it's in the stomach. One's in the lower small intestine and makes you feel full. And if obesity is not a character defect, a lack of willpower, sadness because mother didn't love you, if instead it's a hormonal or physical or chemical problem, what can we do to treat this? Well, let's cut the vagus nerve. Decrease acid, decrease ghrelin. Let's make the stomach smaller, because the stomach acts as a reservoir. Instead of eating an entire steak, our patient 1 year out could eat a little bit of steak. So we make the stomach smaller, and then we take the stream of food, and why don't we deliver it to the lower small intestine where satiety comes more quickly? And by delivering the food more quickly, by doing the bypass, the food is delivered to the area of peptide YY, it goes up tenfold, and so he eats less, and paradoxically, he's more satisfied. Not only that, what if we could interfere with the digestion and absorption of fat? Well, you and I are water. We don't digest and absorb fat very well. So God has, again, fitted us with a miraculous system to digest and absorb fat. And that's located just beyond the stomach, where the pancreas and the gallbladder are all fitted, so that when greasy food comes out of the stomach, you mix it with bile, a detergent, and pancreatic enzymes, which help you digest and absorb fat. And when we bypass that whole mechanism, the digestion and absorption of fat goes down. So the surgery then decreases ghrelin, decreases the size of the stomach, decreases hunger, bypasses the duodenum, decreases fat digestion and absorption, and increases peptide YY.
Thank you.
A long run for a short slide, but the answer is we can cut your vagus.
Okay.
Other questions from Orange County?
Why is it not sufficient just to cut the nerve?
They've tried it. Obesity you can think about as Goliath, and you and I are going up against Goliath. And in fact, all these people in here, they've all battled this beast of obesity. And they've tried all kinds of things. Diet and exercise, Atkins diet, and then we know lots of other doctors have tried other things. They've done a lap band in Our Lady Who Had the Lap Band. They've done stomach stapling. And what you see is a whole history. You look over this battlefield, and this Goliath keeps winning the battle. So when we go into battle, we need to realize obesity is no pushover. Okay? We're going up against a competitor that routinely wins. We routinely fail. But the MGB doesn't fail. Did you see the guy here lost 140 pounds? Okay. That's because we went after the vagus nerve and the stomach and the ghrelin, and the digestion and absorption of fat and increased peptide YY. And we feel only by bringing all of those resources to bear can we successfully attack and win obesity. And they have tried to just cut the vagus nerve. And people and animals lose about 10% of their body weight. So a 300-pound person loses 30 pounds.
Okay, I actually have one more thing.
Sure.
I probably wouldn't be here except for diabetes.
Right. Yeah.
Just being fat alone wouldn't probably have gotten me here.
Right.
But when I'm looking at your stats, it looked like the statistics that you had was a sample of about, 114 or 115 patients or something.
Depends
and
on which
those,
study.
And of those that had diabetes, the rate of remission
85%.
Right. Is that pretty typical? Why don't the other 15% lose the diabetes as well?
That's a good question.
We know
from other research that basically the worse the diabetes when you arrive, the more difficult it is to cure.
Okay, that makes sense.
And let's talk about how diabetes occurs and then how we cure it with the bypass. And notice I did use the word cure, which is kind of wild. diabetes occurs when the body is needing insulin to put sugar into the cells of the body. The body cells said, we need sugar out here to run the system. It's the gasoline that runs our system. And it says, I need sugar in the cells. I need sugar in the cells. Insulin is the hormone that brings it into the cells. And as a person gets heavier, they become resistant to the insulin, so they need more insulin. So they send a signal to the pancreas, I'm not happy. I need more insulin because I'm not getting the sugar I need. So the pancreas puts out more sugar, which actually, as a side effect, puts on more fat. Then you become more resistant, and you need more insulin, and you get more sugar. And it gets progressively worse. Until a type 2 diabetic has sky-high insulin levels and sky-high sugar levels, which doesn't make sense, except by explaining as insulin resistance. Now, a question that came up several years ago is, we know that weight loss helps diabetics get better. So one question you might ask yourself is, which is better to get rid of your diabetes? Being really willful and starting on a diet and exercise program today where you lost weight, or if you had a gastric bypass and both patients lost the same amount, which is better? Which is better? Or are they the same? Maybe they're the same. In other words, just weight loss. Or is there something about the gastric bypass that makes it different?
Since you're asking the question, it has to be MGB is better.
You think? Here's what they did. Some scientists in France did gastric bypasses on mice.
Yeah.
So you have to have a lot of respect for it, okay? And they did these mice, and then, of course, after the gastric bypass, these mice that they had selected were obese diabetic mice. They're genetically obese diabetic mice. And as they started to lose weight, they took another group of mice and controlled their feedings so that one group and the other group both lost the same amount of weight. But the diabetes was resolved in the gastric bypass patients much better. How can that be? Well, it turns out when you bypass the pancreas, where the pancreatic islet cells create the insulin, there is an uptick in pro-insulinogenic hormones called glucagon-like peptide 1 and gastrointestinal peptide. And I love to say this, GLP and GIP. So both GLP and GIP go up after gastric bypass. And so what we find is that when we do a gastric bypass and get weight loss, we get more than weight loss. We get an improvement in the pro-insulinogenic hormones. Plus, studies have also shown that gastric bypass patients get a hyperplasia of the pancreatic islet cells in diabetics. In other words, they get bigger and more cells that make insulin in their pancreas. And that doesn't come from weight loss alone. It comes from the bypass of that area beyond the stomach called the duodenum.
Is this for lifetime?
Yeah.
Okay, so this may be a situation where it doesn't work.
Okay.
You have polycystic ovarian disease. Hormones are really messed up. Already picked up diabetes. Very young, 23. We're not even sure she can have children because of it. And the hormones, she is 23, menopause.
Whoa.
And
boy,
so,
I got the answer. Just stop. Because I'm so happy. I can barely stand it.
Can you tell me she'd get pregnant with this too?
Yeah, I can. This is like really cool. You know, when somebody asks a question like this, I want to pay you $5 for that question. That was a great question. Mike, $20 for that question. In fact, here, I got to